Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to my marathon series. You guys are new here, welcome. My name is Becca. I am a registered dietitian and I am currently training for my second marathon, which is the Chicago Marathon. I believe this is my fifth marathon episode, so if you have not seen the first few episodes, definitely make sure to go back and watch those. I share a lot of different things, just really good tips, what to eat for running, how to hydrate for running, as well as like my training schedule, what I'm doing, all fun stuff like that. But in today's video, I'm gonna be talking all about running gear. So all of the stuff you need to equip you to get you through marathon training. So if you are training for a longer distance run, for example, like a half marathon, marathon, or beyond, these are all things that you're definitely going to need. If you're training for a shorter run, maybe like a 10K and below, you're not necessarily going to need all of this stuff, but it is helpful if you think you may run a long run, like a longer distance in the future, you're definitely gonna need some of this stuff. So just a quick rundown how these videos usually go. I talk all about our topic of the day, which today is going to be running gear. I then give you a quick tip, and then also at the end, I will go over how my personal training is doing. I am kind of like light at the end of the tunnel. I still have a little ways to go, but I will talk all about that at the end and fill you guys in on how that's going. Okay, so the very first thing that you need when you're running is an obvious one, and that is a pair of running shoes. So your shoes are probably going to be the most important things you invest in as someone who is going to run medium to long distances. So these are the shoes that I have. They are by Mizuno. I am personally a big fan of Mizuno. These are the Wave Inspire 12. So here's the thing with shoes that is so incredibly important. I'm a fan of Mizuno, these are the shoes I have, but that does no way, by any means, mean that you should run out and get these shoes, because everyone's feet are different, everyone's gait is different, so it is so important. If you're going to run any kind of, you know, decent running distance, you have to get the shoes that are right for you. So you need to go to a running store or a running company, find a store in your area, and you'll just go and you'll actually walk. They'll have, the employees will have you walk, whether it's just up and down one of the aisles in the store or on a treadmill, and they will actually watch how your feet kind of land. I don't want to put my shoe on my desk. They'll watch how your feet land on the ground, and then they will then recommend a few different pairs of shoes that would fit you best, and then you can try them on, you can run outside and test them out. You just have to make sure that you're getting the right shoes for you. For me personally, my feet kind of turn in a little bit when I land on the ground, so it's really important for me to have a very supportive running shoe, but everyone's feet are different. Everyone, you know, walks or runs differently, so it's so important to get shoes that are going to support your specific needs. So do not go to any old store and buy the most colorful pair or the brand that you think is coolest. Like, no. If you're gonna run, you gotta get the right shoes for you. So make sure you do it right. The next thing you will need is some kind of running watch. So the reason you want a running watch is because this will track your mileage. So as you're on your run, especially for the longer runs, you can just look down at your wrist, you can see what pace you're going, you can see how far you've gone, and you can also see like your total time. And then it will also, most watches will also track your heart rate, so it'll be able to tell you your heart rate, as well as like calories burned and all of that fun info. There are phone apps that you can use, like Map My Run and things like that, to help you track the distance of your runs, which is great, but if you are gonna be running, I mean, if you're gonna be training for any kind of distance run, you're gonna be running multiple times a week, you're gonna wanna invest in a good watch that you can rely on and use, and it's so much easier than having to use your phone, and sometimes the phone isn't reliable and you might not have service. So I would definitely recommend getting a running watch. The one that I have is by TomTom. If I were to buy another one, I would get a Garmin, because those are like the gold standard when it comes to like fitness watches, and I don't think the pricing is necessarily all that different. But I would make sure to just get a running watch. Look at reviews online, you can see which one you think would work best for you, but this is the one that I have. Next thing you're going to want on your runs is some headphones. So the headphones that I have are by the brand Jaybird, and I have the X3s, I believe. So I actually just recently got these. These are Bluetooth headphones, so they don't have any wires that connect to anything. You just put them in each of your ears, and there's just a little bit of a wire in the back, and it just doesn't really bother you, which is really, really nice. But I will say, you don't need fancy headphones. Out of anything I'm gonna show you today, these are the least required. Some people don't like to run with any music. I am not one of those people. I like to run with music. So I definitely need headphones, but I used my little iTunes headphones that came with my phone for years. I ran my first marathon with those headphones. They worked completely fine, so you do not need fancy headphones. But this time around, I just decided to upgrade a little bit. So I like them because they fit really, really well in your ears. They have like these little fins that stick out, and they go like into your ear canal, and then obviously the earbuds as well are pretty comfortable. And with these ones, I got them off of Amazon. I will leave them linked down below. When you order these, they come with a bunch of different sizes of these little fins, and then also like the earbuds, so you can interchange them to find like the fit that's best for your ears, because obviously everyone's ears are like different sizes and very different. Overall, these have been working pretty well for me as far as staying in my ears. My one ear, I never have an issue. It's literally never come out, and I've been wearing these a lot. But my other ear, I do have a little bit of a problem with it slipping out sometimes. I am gonna try and like rearrange the little pieces to see if that fits better. But I think the main reason is because the little volume bar is on this side, and it tends to just weigh this side down a little bit. So what I did was, it comes with this little tiny clip. It comes in the package when you buy it. So I will just clip it to my shirt, so it kind of keeps it like stable, like it's not leaning towards one side, if that makes sense. And that seems to help a lot. Honestly, I think this is my one ear that's like, yeah. This one ear is normal and round, and this one is like all jacked up and pointy. I don't know what happened in utero, but Matt has these exact same ones, and he's never had an issue with them ever falling out, so it's probably just me and my weird ear. But yes, I have mainly been loving these. They've been great. The sound quality is good. I love not having like a wire that I could accidentally like hit while I'm running, and then my earbuds pop out, which is just so frustrating, especially when you're tired on a run and you're like 3 hours in. That's just like not something you want to be dealing with. And along with headphones, of course, is you need some good music. So sometimes I will listen to Pandora stations, sometimes I will listen to podcasts, and then sometimes I listen to the playlist that I have made myself. So when I listen to Pandora stations, typically I will listen to like the Chainsmokers radio. You guys can look that up. I really like that one. It has just like good upbeat songs for the most part. Sometimes I listen to podcasts, but that's not that often, because music usually keeps me more distracted and just keeps me like more energized. And then as far as my playlist, I'm gonna try and find a way to like link it down below. I don't have a Spotify account, so I don't really like know how that works. But I will try and find a way to leave the songs that I like listening to while I'm running down below. And then obviously you need something to play your music from, so I always just bring my phone, but it is annoying to run with your phone. I don't like having it in my hand. It just like annoys me, and anything to keep you like in a happy, positive mindset while you're on a long run especially, like I will do anything to keep that. So I have this little arm band that I keep my phone in. This is like a cheapo one I got off of Amazon. I don't even know if the brand is on here, but I will link it down below. I think it was like 10 bucks. And it fits on your arm really nice. There is like a little slot to put like a key in, which I really like. I use that a lot. So yeah, I use this on my arm and it works great. And the next thing that you're going to need is a lovely, God, I just love this thing, a running belt. So real sexy. Honestly, I feel like extremely hot when I put this on, I gotta say. So this one is by Nathan. My mom says it looks like I have udders when I wear this, which is just super cute. But now I wear it on my back, so it's not as weird. Before, I used to wear it on my front, which is like, just don't do that. So this one is by Nathan, I think. Yes, Nathan. I also got this off of Amazon. I bought this, I don't know, over a year ago, and I used this for my first marathon through the training, and I also wore it on the day of. Some people don't even wear their belts during the actual marathon because there's so many hydration stations, but I just like to carry a lot of stuff, like a lot of like goos or gummies and chapstick, because I'm a nut job. So I like to wear this anyway during the race. But so basically it's just a belt. You've got a pouch in the middle here. Something just fell out of this. And then it comes, mine at least comes with two water bottles that are like 9 ounces, I think. 8 ounces, 9 ounces, something like that. So I will fill these up with water or fill one with like an electrolyte drink, and you just wear this bad boy, and it's kind of annoying, but you do get used to it. Like, you kind of don't even feel it after a while. And it does kind of make you like a little sore, like where the, like where it's just around your body, because it's just really tight and like bouncing around. But it really is like necessary. If you're gonna be on a long run, especially if you don't have access to water, you have got to bring this with you, because it's a lifesaver. And I can't believe I almost forgot this, but my next thing is you want a hat or some kind of visor, anything like that. I actually have two that I like to wear. So this first one is like my trusty running hat. I wore this on my first marathon. It's just like a small Under Armour hat that's like really breathable and nice. And I love this one, but lately I've been stealing, this is Matt's hat, it is a men's hat, and it just has like a much bigger brim, and it's actually a lot more comfortable than the other one, so I've been stealing that a lot lately. But there are two reasons that I like to wear hats. Like, why am I so out of breath right now? So the first reason I like to wear a hat is because I just like to protect my face from the sun. When you're on long runs, especially if you're training in the summertime where it's really hot and you're outside, you're in the sun for like 3+ hours, which can be, I mean, that's a long time to be in the sun. I would never lay out in the sun just like that. So I always wear sunscreen, but that is especially why I like to have a hat, because I just like my face to be shaded as much as possible. So that's the main reason. But then also the second reason, which is kind of random, but it like really makes a difference for me, is wearing a hat helps me just like really get in the zone. It almost like literally puts like blinders on you, like not in a dangerous way where you can't see what's going on, but it just like helps me focus, because I don't know, I just like having like that brim above my head. Plus, if you're running outdoors, this is something that I experienced, if you're running in an area where there's like a lot of trees, which there's a ton of trees around where I live and where I run, if there's sun shining and you're running by all of these trees, it's gonna be like almost like a blinking light, and it's really distracting and it's really annoying. So I always wear a hat just for that, because it can get really frustrating when you're on your run. And like I said, anything to keep you happy, positive, and not annoyed during a run makes such a difference. So that is another reason that I can't run without a hat. So that is everything for my running gear. I feel like I might get questions about clothing as far as running, and to be honest, I'm just not super picky about it. I get a lot of my stuff from the Nike outlet, because there's one semi close to where I live, and I just don't like spending a lot of money on workout clothes. I do like to invest in leggings though, and I have some pairs from Lululemon that I really, really like, and I do think are worth the splurge, because they're just really high quality and last forever. I have not worn them during this training because it's been a million degrees, but I did wear them all the time for the first marathon I trained for, because that was in the winter. My running tip this week is to listen to your body as much as possible during training. Training is really challenging because it's kind of rigorous. I mean, you have anywhere from 4 to 5, maybe even more runs a week, and you really have to stick to the training if you want to feel good and be able to run that full race at the end feeling good and feeling like you're ready for it. But sometimes, you know, we get a little under the weather and we just don't feel 100%, and you really have to listen to your body on that and make your best judgment call. Sometimes it's better to skip a run if you think you're going to heal faster and feel better faster. Whereas if you're just like, you know, I have to do this run even though I feel achy and I'm not really up for it, it may just extend you feeling crappy, and therefore you may end up missing even more runs. And then as far as how my training is going, it is going, I would say, pretty well. But I will say, hands down, this training has been a lot more challenging for me than the first time around. I think it has a lot to do with the weather. I just do not do well training in the heat and the sun and the humidity. It's just, I mean, Matt's doing fine. Like, his runs are going great. Of course he's hot, but he's doing fine. Whereas when we trained in the winter, he was struggling a lot more, and there were some runs that he maybe didn't complete the full mileage because he just, like, his body wasn't feeling it. And that's definitely been me this time around. We've definitely kind of swapped places. The longest run I've done so far is 18 miles. I still have 2 really long runs left up to 20 miles, and then I will finally be tapering. But during that 18-mile run, oh my god, I honestly felt great the whole time. I mean, it's hard. Like, running that long is really hard. But overall, I felt really good up until the very end. I would say, like, the last 3 to 4 miles, I really started to, I think I hit a wall. I think that was the first time in my running career I've ever, like, legitimately hit a wall where my body was like, I need to stop. But because I'm just a very determined person and I was so close, like, at that point I'm like, I ran 15 miles, I'm getting my 18 miles in. And in hindsight, I think I should have just stopped, because afterwards I actually got really sick and I was like throwing up a lot, which has never happened to me before. So that just goes to show that this is like, this training this time around actually is like physically harder on me. It's not just my mind, I'm not just being lazy, like it just has been taking a lot more out of me. But I am chugging along, I'm trying to stay positive. I know the marathon is going to be, fingers crossed, easier because of the crowds and the excitement and all the adrenaline. So I'm looking forward to the race very much so. Just gotta get these two really long runs out of the way. But yeah, that is all I have for this video. I hope that you guys are enjoying this series and are just enjoying kind of following me on this training journey. I know a lot of you guys are currently training for half marathons and marathons, which is awesome. I hope that your training is going well. And just know that I am over here cheering you on. I am putting in the work just like you, day in and day out. And I know it can be hard. So just know that I am right there with you, girl or guy, whoever is training. But make sure to subscribe if you guys haven't already. I'm definitely going to be vlogging the marathon weekend and as much as the marathon as I can. So definitely stay tuned for that. It's crazy that that's like on the horizon. I'm excited. Oh, and today is September 1st. And the marathon is in October, so we are getting close, people. Oh God, thank God, I'm so ready. You can also follow me on Instagram and Snapchat as well. I would love to hang out with you guys over on those platforms. But that is all for this video. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today, and I will see you in the next video. Bye. Should have forgotten.